Dear children, good morning everybody. This is third video of the supplementary reader Tempest. Okay, so let us continue the same. So in the previous class we have seen Prospero and Miranda, that is Miranda is the daughter of Prospero. Both of them were living in an island, and we have seen new characters in the last video, that is Antonio, brother of Prospero, and one more person, King of Naples, who is the friend of Antonio and enemy of Prospero. So with the help of his magic power, Prospero had created a storm in the sea. Okay, so we have seen till then. Now let us continue. So Miranda is telling, that is, she is asking her father, how did he create the storm? Okay, now then, said her father, that by means of the storm, my enemies, the king of Naples and my cruel brother, are cast ashore upon this island. Okay, so now then, said her father. Whose father? Miranda's father, that is Prospero. So what he is telling, that by means of the storm, that is by creating the storm, my enemy. So who is the enemy of Prospero? King of Naples and his brother. Okay, so my enemies, the king of Naples and my cruel brother. So why he is addressing his brother Antonio as cruel is because he had let him and his daughter in a boat without any belongings. Okay, because he wants to become the Duke of Milan, that is King of Milan. Okay, so are cast ashore upon this island. Okay, are cast ashore upon this island. So what does mean by cast ashore? Throwing someone by force. Okay, so what had happened? His brother Antonio had set him in a boat, and he had let him and his daughter in the boat without any food and clothings. Right. So now then, said her father, that by means of this storm, my enemies, the king of Naples and my cruel brother, are cast ashore upon this island. So Miranda is asking her father, what is the reason for creating this storm? So what is the explanation given by Prospero is, why he had created this storm is because he had thrown King of Naples and his brother Antonio ashore in the island. Having so said, Prospero gently touched his daughter with his magic wand, and she felt asleep. For the spirit Ariel just then presented himself before his master to give an account of the tempest and how he had disposed of the ship's company. And though the spirits were always invisible to Miranda, Prospero did not choose she should hear him holding conversation with the empty air. Okay, so having so said, Prospero gently touched his daughter with his magic wand. So magic wand means magic stick. So all the magicians will have a magic stick, right? So magic wand means magic stick. Okay. So Prospero, what Prospero had done is he had touched his daughter with his magic stick so that Miranda, she felt asleep. So Miranda felt asleep. For the spirit Ariel just then presented himself before his master to give an account of the tempest. So, why Prospero had made his daughter to feel asleep is because now the spirit Ariel is appearing before Prospero to explain about the tempest, that is the storm created in the sea. Okay, and how he had disposed of the ship's company and how he had disposed all the persons in the ship. And though the spirits were always invisible to Miranda. So, all the spirits will not be visible to Miranda. It will be visible only to Prospero. So, Though the spirits were always invisible to Miranda, Prospero did not choose she should hear him holding conversation with the empty air. Okay, so now you may have a doubt. What is it? So spirits will be invisible to Miranda. Okay, then why Prospero should make his daughter Miranda to feel asleep? Now Ariel had appeared before Prospero to give a demonstration about the storm he had created in the sea and what happened to all the crew members, that is the persons who had sailed in the ship, and everything Ariel wants to explain to his master Miranda. So now when Prospero is hearing all this from Ariel, what Miranda will think? Her father is making a conversation with the empty air. So காத்துல ஏதோ பேசிட்டு இருக்காரு வித் த எம்டி ஏர். ஓகே, ஷீல் பி திங்கிங் ஸோ ரைட். ஸோ தட்ஸ் வே ஷீ இஸ் மேக்கிங் ஹர் டாட்டர் டு ஃபீல் அஸ்லீப் பிகாஸ் ஹீ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு டிஸ்கஸ் அபவுட் த டெம்பஸ்ட் வித் ஹூம், வித் ஏரியல். ரைட், நவ் லெட் அஸ் கோ ஃபார் நெக்ஸ்ட். வெல் மை பிரேவ் ஸ்பிரிட், செட் ப்ராஸ்பரோ டு ஏரியல், ஹவு ஹாவ் யூ பெர்ஃபார்ம்ட் யுவர் டாஸ்க்? Okay, so what Prospero is asking? Well, my brave spirit. So, Prospero is telling the spirit to be very brave. Okay, it is a very brave spirit. Said Prospero to Ariel, how have you performed your task? Task means some work. Okay, so what is the work here? Creating storm in the sea. Okay, so how have you performed? How have you done this work? Ariel gave a lively description of the storm and of the terrors of the mariners and how the king's son Ferdinand. So now we are seeing a new character. What is it? Ferdinand. So who is Ferdinand? Ferdinand is the son of King of Naples. Okay, Ferdinand is the son of King of Naples. Okay, and how the king's son Ferdinand was the first who leaped into the sea. And his father thought he saw his dear son swallowed up by the waves and lost. But he is safe, said Ariel, in a corner of the isle, sadly lamenting the loss of the king, his father. Okay, now what Ariel is doing is, it is giving a lively description. It is describing about the storm and of the terrors. Terror means fear. Okay, and of the terrors of the mariners. Mariners means all the persons who sailed in the ship. And how the king's son Ferdinand was the first who leaped into the sea. Leaped means jumped. Okay, so who is the first person to jump into the sea? Is Ferdinand. Okay, and his father. Whose father? Ferdinand's father. So who is Ferdinand's father? King of Naples. Okay. And his father thought he saw his dear son swallowed up by the waves and lost. So, his father, that is King of Naples, is nakedly seeing that his son is swallowed up by the waves and lost and disappeared. So, when there is a heavy storm in the sea, what will happen when we are jumping into the sea? We will be getting inside the huge waves in the sea. Right, so likewise he is seeing his son swallowed up by the waves and disappeared. But he is safe, said Ariel. Okay, but Ariel is telling that he is safe in a corner of the isle. So where he landed is in a corner of the island, sadly lamenting the loss of the king, his father. So lamenting means expressing some sadness. Okay, so he is sadly lamenting the loss of the king. So who is the king? His father, King of Naples. So he is lamenting, he is worried about the loss of his father. See here father thinks that his son Ferdinand had been disappeared in the sea. Okay, but here Ferdinand is worrying that he had lost his father in the storm. So now one thing you have to remember. So in spite of creating the storm in the sea, why everyone is safe? Why Ariel is safe? Because already in the first class, in the first page, we have seen that even though storm is created by Prospero, what is the condition? No one in the ship will be hurt. You can see these lines in the first page. Okay, so no one, so the storm is created by the Prospero in such a way that no one in the ship will be dying. Everyone will be alive. So then why Prospero had created this storm is because he wants to give some punishment to his brother Antonio and to the king of Naples. So that is the reason why he had created this storm, but no one in the ship will be dying. That's my delicate Ariel, said Prospero. So delicate means happiness here. Okay, that's my delicate Ariel, said Prospero. Bring him here. So here him refers to whom? Him refers to Ferdinand. Bring him here. My daughter must see this young prince, because my daughter has to see the young prince. So why his daughter has to see the young prince means because he had not seen any other human being except her father. Okay, so where is the king and my brother? And now Prospero is asking, where is the king? King means king of Naples and my brother. Brother means Antonio. Okay, he is asking about the king of Naples and his brother Antonio. And also he is asking Ariel to bring Ferdinand there to the island. I left them, answered Ariel, searching for Ferdinand, whom they have little hopes of finding, thinking they saw him perish. Okay, I left them, answered Ariel. So Ariel is replying, I had left them searching for Ferdinand. Okay, so who is searching for Ferdinand? So here them refers to whom? Them refers to Antonio and King of Naples. I left them searching for Ferdinand. So for whom they are searching? Antonio and King of Naples were searching for Ferdinand, whom they have little hopes of finding. And also, but even though Antonio and King of Naples were searching for Ferdinand, they don't have hope, they don't have confidence of finding them, thinking they saw him perish, because they are thinking that they saw him perish. Perish means, okay, so they, because who is that? King of Naples is saying that he is directly seeing his son Ferdinand jumping into the sea, and he is swallowed by the waves and he had disappeared. So he doesn't have confidence that he'll be able to find his son again. Okay, of the ship's crew, not one is missing, though each one thinks himself the only one saved, and the ship, though invisible to them, is safe in the harbor. Okay, so of the ship's crew, crew means the person who had sailed in the ship. Okay, so of the ship's crew, so among all the persons who had sailed in the ship, not one is missing. So nobody is missing, though each one thinks himself the only one saved, but every one of them thinks that they are the only person saved. So everyone, ஒவ்வொருத்தரும் என்ன நினைக்கிறாங்கனா, நான் மட்டும்தான் உயிரோடு இருக்கேன் அப்படின்னு நினச்சிக்கிறாங்க. ஓகே, பட் எவ்ரி ஒன் இஸ் சேஃப். அண்ட் த ஷிப், தோ இன்விசிபிள் டு தெம், அண்ட் ஆல்சோ த ஷிப் இஸ் ஆல்சோ வெரி சேஃப். ஈவன் தோ இட் இஸ் நாட் விசிபிள் டு தெம், இட் இஸ் சேஃப் இன் த ஹார்பர். த ஷிப் இஸ் ஆல்சோ சேஃப் இன் த ஹார்பர். தட் இஸ் நோ ஒன் இன் த ஷிப் இஸ் கெட்டிங் ஹர்ட், இன்க்ளூடிங் த ஷிப். ஷிப் இஸ் ஆல்சோ நாட் டேமேஜ்ட். Ariel then went to fetch Ferdinand. So fetch means bring. Okay, so Ariel then went to bring Ferdinand. Oh, my young gentleman, said Ariel when he saw him, I will soon move you. You must be brought, I find, for the lady Miranda to have a sight of your pretty person. Come, sir, follow me. Okay. Oh, my young gentleman. So, whom he is addressing like that? Ariel is addressing Ferdinand. Oh, my young gentleman, I will soon move you. So, move you means soon I will take away you from this place. I will soon move you. You must be brought. Okay, you should be brought. So, it is the order of Prospero that you should be brought. I find for the lady Miranda to have a sight of your pretty person, because Miranda have to see you. Miranda should see you, see such a beautiful prince. Come, sir, follow me. So, come on, follow me. So, Ariel is telling this to Ferdinand. Okay. He followed in amazement. Amazement means surprise, shocking. Okay, so it is very much shocking to Ferdinand. So why it is shocking is because he was not able to see the spirit Ariel. Okay, it is not visible to Ferdinand, but he could hear only the voice of the Ariel. So he was very much shocked. He was very much surprised, wondered. He followed in amazement. So he is following the sound in surprise. The sound of Ariel's voice, till it led him to Prospero and Miranda, who were sitting under the shade of a large tree. Okay, so Ferdinand is following Ariel till it had taken them to Prospero and Miranda. So where they were sitting is, they were sitting under the shadow of a large tree. Now Miranda had never seen a man before except her own father. So we have already seen that Miranda had never seen a man before except her own father. She had not seen any other human being except her father. Miranda, said Prospero, tell me what you are looking at yonder. Okay, so what you are looking in surprise? Prospero is asking to her daughter Miranda, tell me, my dear, what you are looking in surprise. Oh, father, said Miranda in a strange surprise, surely that is a spirit. Lord, how it looks about? Believe me, it is a beautiful creature. Is it not a spirit? Okay, so, oh, my dear father, Miranda is telling in a strange surprise, in an unknown surprise. Very much she is wondered, surely that is a spirit. What is that? It is definitely a spirit. So, whom she is telling as a spirit is, she is telling Ferdinand as a spirit. Okay, why she is telling Ferdinand as a spirit is, to her knowledge, the only human being in the earth is her father Prospero. So, she is thinking Ferdinand as a spirit. Surely that is a spirit. Lord, how it looks about? Okay, believe me, it is a beautiful creature. So, she is telling, believe me, father, it is a beautiful creature. Is it not a spirit? She is asking to her father, is it not a spirit? No girl, answered her father, it eats and sleeps and has senses such as we have. No, my dear daughter, it can eat, it can sleep, and it has all senses such as we have. Okay, this young man you see was in the ship. Okay, the young man whom you are seeing now was in the ship. He is somewhat altered by grief, or you might call him a handsome person. He has lost his companions and is wandering about to find them. Okay, so this young man was in the ship. So what happened is, now he is in a sorrow. Grief means sadness, sorrowness. Okay, now he is in a sorrowness because, or you might call him a handsome person. Okay, so actually this beautiful person was in the ship. Now he is somewhat depressed, feeling sad, or else he will be a handsome person. He has lost his companions. Okay, so why he is sad is because he had lost all his companions, all his friends and father and relations, neighbors, everyone in the ship. and is wandering. Wandering means roaming here and there in search of something. Okay, wandering about to find them, and he is wandering here and there to find the persons, find his companions. That's why he is looking very sad. Miranda, who thought all men had grave faces and grey beards like her father, was delighted with the appearance of this beautiful young prince. And Ferdinand, seeing such a lovely lady in this desert place, and from the strange sounds he had heard, expecting nothing but wonders. Okay, expecting nothing but wonders. Thought he was upon an enchanted island, and that Miranda was the goddess of the place, and as such he began to address her. So what happened is, okay, Miranda, who thought all men had grave faces and grey beards like her father. So she is thinking that all men, so all the male persons had grave faces like her. So grave face like her father and grey beard. Beard, you know, all of you know what is beard, right? Grey beards like her father. That is, she is thinking that all the male persons will be very old like her father. Was delighted. Delighted means feeling very much happy. Okay, so was delighted with the appearance of this beautiful young prince. Oh, so Miranda thought that if there are some other male person in this world, they'll be looking like her father. Okay, but after seeing her, after seeing this young prince Ferdinand, she was feeling very much happy. And Ferdinand, so this is the feeling of Miranda. Now what is the feeling of Ferdinand is, Ferdinand seeing such a lovely lady in this desert place, in that lonely place. Desert means here, not desert area, in that lonely place. And from the strange sounds he had heard. Okay, so Ferdinand is also very happy about seeing such a beautiful. So Miranda is a beautiful girl, right? So Ferdinand is also equally happy on seeing such a beautiful lady in that place. And from the strange sounds he had heard. And also, what is the strange sound he had heard? He had heard the sound of Ariel. Okay. Expecting nothing but wonders. So he is not expecting anything because he is fully surrounded by surprise. Okay. Because he don't know how he had came to the island. That is shore of the island. And also he don't know why there is no human being, but he is hearing a voice. And also he is very much surprised to look at a beautiful lady in that island. Okay, so he was completely surrounded by many surprise. Thought he was upon an enchanted island. So he is thinking that he was in an enchanted island. That is like a magic island. And that Miranda was the goddess of the place. And also he is so he was much attracted by the, wondered or surprised, attracted by the beauty of Miranda. And he is thinking that Miranda is the goddess of the place. And as such, he began to address her. Okay, so like a goddess, he is beginning to address. That is, he is beginning to speak to Miranda, thinking that she was the goddess of that island. Okay. Okay, so she was, she timidly answered, she was no goddess, but a simple maid, and was going to give him, an account of herself when Prospero interrupted her. Okay, so she timidly answered, she immediately, okay, shortly, okay, that is suddenly she answered, she was no goddess, no, no, I am not a goddess, but a simple maid, but a simple girl, and was going to give him an account of herself. I am going to tell about myself When Prospero interrupted her, so when they were talking all these things, immediately what happened? Prospero is interrupting, that is, he is speaking in the middle. Okay, he was well pleased. He was well pleased to find they admired each other, but to try Ferdinand's constancy, he resolved to throw some difficulties in their way. Therefore, advancing forward, he addressed the prince with a stern air, telling him he came to the island as a spy to take it from him who was the lord of it. Okay, follow me, said he, I will tie your neck and feet together. You shall drink sea water, shellfish, withered roots, and husk of acorns shall be your food. No, said Ferdinand, I will resist this, and drew his sword. But Prospero, waving his magic wand, fixed him to the spot where he stood, so that he had no power to move. So he was well pleased to find they admired each other. So pleased means feeling happy. Okay, so who was well pleased? Who was very happy? Prospero is very happy to find they admired each other. Okay, admired means attracted. So he was happy to see that Prospero and Ferdinand were attracted towards each other, because Ferdinand had seen such a beautiful girl in the island, and Miranda had never seen such a beautiful person, because he thought that all the human beings, that is especially male persons, will be like her father. Okay, but to try Ferdinand's constancy. So constancy means to check the faithfulness. Okay, to check the faithfulness of whom? Ferdinand. Okay, so but to try Ferdinand's constancy, he wants to check the faithfulness, so check all his qualities, how he is faithful, how much he is believable. Okay, all those he wants to check. So he resolved to throw some difficulties in their way. So he had planned to throw some difficulties. Okay, so that is simply, if we want to say, he wants to check, he wants to keep some test to check the faithfulness of whom? Faithfulness of Ferdinand. Okay, so therefore, advancing forward, he addressed the prince. So coming in front, he is telling to the prince. Who is the prince? Ferdinand. With a stern air, that means he is telling seriously, severely, okay, strictly. Who is telling? Prospero. Telling to whom? Telling to Ferdinand. He came to the island as a spy to take it from him who was the lord of it. So what Prospero is telling is, Ferdinand came to the island as a spy. So why he had came to island as a spy is to take it from him, to take the island from him who was the lord of it. And who is the lord? King of the island. Lord of the island is Prospero. Okay, so he is telling that Ferdinand had came to the island to take the island from Prospero. Follow me, said he, I will tie your neck and feet together. So follow me, I am, because as you came as a spy to take away the island from me, I will give you some punishment. See, I will tie your neck and feet together. Imagine tying the neck and feet together, how it will be, can you imagine? Okay, so I will tie your neck and feet together. You shall drink sea water. So what you have to drink? Sea water. And what you have to eat? Shellfish. All of you know shellfish. Okay, so it will be covered with shell. There will be very minimum less part to eat in it, or probably we may not be able to eat it. Okay, so it is not possible to drink the salt water. It is not possible to eat a shellfish. Withered roots. Withered root means dry roots. Okay, withered roots. And husks of acorns. So acorn is a nut. Okay, so husk of acorn means, do you know what is mean by husk? See, this is the nut. Okay, this is acorn. and husk means these are the husk. Okay, so we can see the husk in the paddy also. So you have to eat the acorns, husks of the acorns. So is it possible to eat this husk? It is not possible, right? And husks of acorns shall be your food. So what is your food? Sea water, shellfish, withered roots and husks of acorns. No, said Ferdinand, I will resist this, I will oppose this, and drew his sword. So he is taking his sword, but Prospero, waving his magic hand, so with the help of his magic stick, fixed him to the spot where he stood. So he is making him not to move from the spot, that is the place where he is standing, so that he had no power to move, so that he will not be able to move. So it is nothing but to check the quality, to check the faithfulness of Ferdinand. Prospero is telling that Ferdinand had came to the island as a spy to take the island from Prospero. Okay, so he is going to check that. So he is going to give him some simple punishment. What is it? Drinking seawater, eating shellfish, withered roots and husks of acorns. So is it possible for a person to live by eating all this? Definitely no. And also Ferdinand is a person who is not a spy. Okay, so he is resisting this, he is opposing this, Ferdinand is opposing this, and so he is taking his sword. But what Prospero is doing, he is stopping him to not to move away from that place with the help of his magic. Okay, so I hope every one of you have understood till this. Let us continue in the next class. Thank you.